Begin by settling into your body and finding a position that feels comfortable for you. Maybe you're sitting on a cushion or on a chair. Maybe you'd like to lie down. Maybe at some point during this practice period, you feel called to move. In any case, establish yourself in a comfortable position, knowing that it's okay to feel good in your body for this practice. It's helpful. And relax your body, noticing if there's muscular tension and gently inviting it to relax. And if you'd like, invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. Just a simple smile. Doesn't have to be a huge grin. Notice what this feels like in your body, to be comfortable and relaxed with a smile on your face. Are there any pleasant sensations in your body from any of these qualities or anything else? Notice those and really enjoy them, even if they're small. Enjoy what feels good in your body. See if you can maintain these qualities during the practice period, establishing yourself in them and returning to them if needed. It's okay to feel good in your body. And begin to involve your mind by reflecting on different aspects of your life that you're grateful for. Could be big things or small things, totally ordinary things, or things that are particular to this specific chapter of your life. Reflect on what you're grateful for and tell yourself about it. I feel grateful for the food that I had to eat today. I feel grateful for my friends. I feel grateful that I have meaningful work. Whatever it is that you're grateful for, tell yourself about it. If you notice any feelings of gratitude arise as you do this practice, if you feel grateful, again, notice that and really enjoy it. Savor those feelings, even if they're small. So often we throw away small positive feelings that we experience by not paying attention to them, by not enjoying them. Practice really enjoying what's pleasant about your experience. If any feelings of gratitude did arise for you, see if you can keep them around, even as we transition. Bring to mind your easy-to-love person or animal, whoever that is for you. Someone who you love and have a relatively uncomplicated relationship with. Perhaps a friend or family member. Small child or pet. See them in your mind's eye and imagine them being happy, smiling or laughing, playing, succeeding at something that they care about. And use that visualization as a way to cultivate the desire that they might be happy, to wish them well. Again, if you notice any feelings of love arise for you, as you cultivate this goodwill and friendliness towards your easy-to-love person or animal, notice those feelings and really enjoy them. Savor that love. This love is something you can return to at any time. Something you can always find again. Again, if feelings of love have arisen for you, see if you can maintain them and even grow them, even as we transition away from our connection to this easy-to-love person or animal. Let your heart be like a fire that you tend. Allow yourself to become aware of the breath, the inhale and the exhale. Noticing what your breathing feels like right now. As you feel your breathing, imagine that somewhere in your body is a black, tarry lump of coal. This is a wound that's been passed down to you from your parents and their parents. Through your family for centuries. This is an ancestral trauma. It may or may not be associated with particular theme or content. See if you can imagine that now as a black, tarry lump of coal in your body. Simply breathe into it, being aware of your breath, being aware of this ancestral trauma. perhaps your heart on witnessing this trauma, being aware of it. Transmute the love that's present into compassion, an awareness of all of the suffering that you and your family have experienced, and the wholesome desire that that suffering might be resolved, that this trauma might be ended. If it's available for you, feel compassion in your heart. It's as if you're juggling several different balls at once, an awareness of the breath, an awareness of this ancestral trauma, perhaps visualizing it in your body as a black, tarry lump of coal, and compassion in your heart, the intention that this suffering might be resolved. If it feels interesting and fun for you, try adding another ball. That on the inhale, you breathe in this black tarry substance, and on the exhale, you transmute it into white healing light that returns to the same place in your body. That deeply heals your family, your line. Visualize purifying this trauma. As with juggling, if this proves difficult, you can always set a ball down. There's no need to make it overly difficult. Choose the difficulty level that feels good for you. And if for some reason this is overwhelming or painful, you can always return to cultivating love for your easy to love person or animal. But if it's fun and interesting, see if you can connect to and purify this ancestral wound. without needing to understand it or prove it. Allow yourself to imagine for a moment that this is having real effects on your line. This is really healing your family. That your ancestors are grateful to you for doing this work. Something that was painful and difficult for so long is a little lighter for the breath that you're taking now because of the compassion that you're cultivating. Good. Now, take a moment to consider if there's some way that this compassion might like to manifest in your life. Some act of kindness that you might be moved to do because of this practice. If anything like that comes to mind, set the intention to do it as you're able. As you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.